If you have a block of clay that usually it's 25 pounds and it's too dry and you want to know how to recycle it, this is how you do it. You break it down. I use a hammer. You break it down to about 1 inch small pieces. Once it's broken, you transfer it to a bucket. We use 5 gallon buckets. Here is the size of the pieces. If you have extra piece of clay that you want to recycle, you can add that to the big chunk we just broke. Keep breaking it. You add water. Water needs to be over the top. 24 hours later, in this case, you can wait longer, as long as you want, but at least 24 hours, you empty the water. That's what it looks like without the water. Then you transfer it to a plasterboard. We use our wedging table to do the recycling. We have other boards if we have large quantity, and you place it. When you have plasterboard, you don't have to be too careful emptying the water totally, but if you use wood, you want to have less water. It's going to take much longer to dry if you have too much water. Then you smooth the corner. You want to not have high points. They're going to dry too hard of a texture. It would be hard to wedge. By smoothing it, you avoid that. You poke holes in the clay to let the air dry it more effectively. It touches more surface on top. The plaster going to do the job on the bottom, and the top it would be air dry. Here's a piece of leather hard clay that not totally dry that I put in to show you what's going to happen if you don't use totally dry clay. This is what the clay needs to look like, at least in our case with our type of clay. That what happens, it doesn't break down if you put clay that it's not totally dry among the other pieces. So try to avoid that, let things dry first. Then the next day, in 24 hours or 36 hours, depending on how long it takes for it to dry, you have to check it every so often. You remove it from the wedging board, and then you start wedging it. If you use the clay for throwing, you want it to be softer. For hand building, you want it to be harder. You place it in a bag. We use 25 pounds bag. Then you mark it to make sure that you remember what clay is in the bag. And you're done. Thank you.